Did you know that computer scientists have been working alongside chatbots as early as the 1960s? And her name was... we'll get to that in a second. You've probably heard of ChatGPT, a computer program that is trained to follow your instruction and provide a variety of wide-ranging responses. As someone that's actually spent some time using the AI, I have to say the results it produces can be eerily human. Today, we're rewinding back and looking at the revolutionary chatbot of the 60s, known formally as ELIZA. We're going to be taking a closer look at the curious world of chatbots and examining the existence of ELIZA and the influences it had on ChatGPT as we know it. Before we jump into the ones and zeros of the computer world, don't forget to smash that subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you never miss out on the nostalgic throwbacks of Ripley's Rewind. Okay, back to business. It was the late 1960s, and Joseph Weizenbaum, an MIT computer scientist, had just completed work on his revolutionary chatbot, ELIZA. Weizenbaum was born in Berlin, Germany in 1923 and fled the country with his family in 1935 to escape the political turmoil at the time. Weizenbaum came to the United States where his road to computer science would begin. After time spent in the Air Force, Weizenbaum would go on to study as a computer scientist and eventually work in the industry. You have to remember, computers at that time were not portable devices that could fit in our pockets. In fact, they often barely fit into a room. As an associate professor at MIT, Weizenbaum became obsessed with the way computers could directly interact with humans through language. It was this early throughline between computers and human language that would work to lay the foundation for his own chatbot, and eventually lay the groundwork for the AI development of programs such as ChatGPT, Siri, and Alexa. Weizenbaum believed that the most effective way to go about creating a connection between human language and computers would be through mimicking the structure of a therapy session. The general idea would be to have ELIZA fixate on keywords and continually ask open-ended questions through a reformatting of the initial remark. ELIZA was completed in 1966, and Weizenbaum offered MIT students the opportunity to interact with the chatbot. This process consisted of messages typed into the computer by students, and responses would then be provided by ELIZA and were routed to an electronic typewriter and printer. The conversations looked a little something like this. "Well, my boyfriend made me come here."
"Your boyfriend made you come here?"
"He says I'm depressed much of the time."
"I'm so sorry to hear you're depressed."
"It's true, I am unhappy."
"Do you think coming here will help you not to be unhappy?"
ELIZA was programmed to fixate on keywords such as girlfriend, depressed, what, mother, and father. In the event that ELIZA had trouble interpreting what the user was asking, the program could fall back on, "Please go on, that's very interesting," or "I see." Although nonspecific in many ways, the phrases helped to create the illusion that one was interacting with a human while simultaneously working to keep a flow in conversation. Believe it or not, throughout the process, students were told to not use question marks when asking questions, as ELIZA interpreted them as a line delete request. Weizenbaum was initially happy with the response that was garnered from users' experience with ELIZA, but there was one thing he did begin to notice that he viewed as considerably concerning. Over time, Weizenbaum made note of users starting to divulge deep personal information, looking for help similar to that of a therapy session. This observation ended up pushing Weizenbaum to advocate for caution when relying too heavily on computers for human thought. Weizenbaum's cautions were further proven when another chatbot system, meant to replicate someone with paranoid schizophrenia, interacted with ELIZA. The conversation went something like this.
"Good evening. Tell me your problems. Please terminate input with a period or a question mark."
"People get on my nerves sometimes."
"I'm not sure I understand you fully."
"You should pay more attention."
"Suppose you should pay more attention."
"You're entitled to your own opinion."
"What makes you think I am entitled to my own opinion?"
Seeing the mixture of responses users had towards ELIZA, and how quickly some were able to conflate a computer program to human interaction, made Weizenbaum weary about the idea of computers being capable of human thought and emotion. ELIZA's one-dimensional interaction with Perry further solidified Weizenbaum's concerns. Coming back to 2023, I can't help but think about what Weizenbaum would have thought regarding ChatGPT. I want to leave you with the quote Weizenbaum made to the New York Times regarding computers replacing human intelligence. "There are aspects to human life that a computer cannot understand. Cannot. It's necessary to be a human being. Love and loneliness have to do with the deepest consequences of our biological constitution. That kind of understanding is in principle impossible for the computer." In the age of advanced AI with ChatGPT, I think Weizenbaum would stand by his early warnings and continue to advocate for caution as we barge full steam ahead into AI. So there you have it. From ELIZA to ChatGPT, humans have continued to fixate on advancing computer technology to eerie levels. To wrap this episode, I fittingly had ChatGPT write the outro. So without further ado, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more content like this. And don't forget to check out some of the other Ripley's Rewind videos on our channel. We are always creating new and exciting content for you to enjoy. If you have any suggestions or requests for future videos, let us know in the comments below. And if you want to stay updated on our latest content and behind the scenes updates, follow Ripley's Believe It or Not on Instagram and TikTok. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.